Welcome to the Drone Network.
Hey guys, MD here. Got a flight controller in front of us here. This is the SP Racing F3 Brushed Edition. As you can see, it's the version 2. And I'm going to use this for a whoop build. I'm up in the air on which frame to use. I say whoop, but I mean a brush build. I'm up in the air. I really want to use this, but the props seem to be a hassle in here, so I have to figure out what props to get, or I already have a carbon fiber frame. And yes, this is from the RC Hunter. I told him before that board went up, and it didn't fly the same after that. So that would probably be cool to put it on this, because those motors would go right in here with the grommets. They had plastic cups that sat in here, and it vibrated around, you know, the motor. But these rubber grommets here would grab that 8mm motor really well and tight and hold it. And then I could use any propeller, triple or biprop, on that behalf. And as you can see, it would just, you know, mount right to it. Never, ever, ever mount your flight controller or any of your components straight to carbon fiber. It is conductive and it will burn stuff up. So let's get that out of the way. What we're going to do here is we're going to pre-tin all these connectors. Now this is able to be used as a hexacopter, motor 1, motor 2, motor 3, motor 4, for a multi-rotor, you know, quad. And then you would use 5 and 6 if you was going to build like a hexacopter or something like that with this. So I think it's cool because you could fly any of your toy grade quads with a digital transmitter, and you could put acro, you know, air mode and all that good stuff on here. So, but it does have another thing I want to touch on. If you do get a hold of these, right here it has, if you connect this pin and this pin, that's going to run you on 2S. And if you connect this pin and this pin, that will run you on 1S. When it comes through, mine was connected for 1S. I did desolder it and get it to 3 legs again instead of just 2. So I have to run over to here and that will be 2S. And then make sure this isn't connected here. It'd be cool if you could connect all 3 and run 3S, right? But I'm not going to try my board and burn it up. So then we're just going to pre-tin motor wires 1, 2, 3, and 4. It does have 3 UARTs on it. For the time, I will only be using UART 1, which I do believe is up here. Your DSM guys, Spectrum, they have you covered here. You can run a, you run your power wires off of here. And they give you a buzzer port here. You could put a buzzer in, or you could run, well, I guess you could also use the UART for your, you could power off the UART or off of this. That's probably just 3 volts, so you probably want to get off of 5 volts. You could pull 5 volts off of, I'm not sure exactly what leg it is. It's going to be one of these legs here, and that would feed your camera. So your little AIO camera, little solder spot popped up there, I see. And that's what I'm talking about here. Because these are fun. You know, this is a 7mm, got insane motors, but it doesn't fly the same. Nothing like this is going to be, you know. So I'll put this camera on here and just solder these wires onto there, and it'll power it through the board. And then I'll use a 2S LiPo. I have a good bit of these hanging around. They will need different connectors, or I'll just put this connector on there, and I may just run an XT30 connector, to be honest with you. So because when you're using these, you want to watch, it's very easy to put this in backwards. I've done it myself, and you guys know how I know things, you know. I'm not the smartest tool in the shed, but anyway, so I'll use these 650s, and if it's not too heavy, which I don't think they are, you could probably put two of these together and make 1300. So they're a holy stone, 3.7, 650 milliamp hour, 2.41 Wh. So they're nice batteries, they last a while too. But you're talking 8mm motor, so. Alright guys, let's go ahead and get this soldered up. This is going to be a long video, so I'll tell you right now. Go to your dollar store. These are really nice. Interactive DNA, I saw this on his channel. It's just a big clothespin. They sell them at your dollar store, and then you just put heat shrink on it. And it works, because you can just set your stuff down. It's way better than the helping hands, because we can just sit down, grab our soldering iron, right, and just come in and start the tin. All right, there's my power wires. And now to our motor wires. I don't like how it's right close onto that. I think that's meant to be. It's a capacitor. Motor number two. And let me get the buzzer while I'm here. Hope you guys are getting this. I'm always usually out of frame, so that's probably no big deal either. And I still got a blob on there, so I'll just dab it on there. Perfect. I'm gonna turn her around here. Clean your tip off. Keep the tip nice and clean. Give it a tap. And there's motor wire number three. I think some are meant to touch, because they run it into that. If you see it, the box comes up, comes in, comes down and around. So that's a capacitor. You kind of want to watch tinning around that. Be real careful, because you can knock that off easy, and then it would not work at all for you. So I do believe that this is UART 1. So we'll go ahead and just dab it up. And then go back and just flow it. That simple. Might touch there, yep. See? Give it a look if you think you touched. No problem if you did. Just correct it before you plug it in. Nobody's perfect here. I've never ever claimed to be perfect on anything. And just, we'll go ahead and do them all. That way we know they're done. Does that make sense? That way we ever need it while we're, on board, we can just go ahead and get it done. I always give like a little blow when I do it, you know, like a kind of keep it out of my face, because stuff is ugly. And anyway, just see standing up, just go on and touch her. And you guys let me know what you think of these solder joints. They're trash, tell me. I'm always willing to learn something. I've never ever said I was the greatest solder. Let's not forget, remember what I told you guys? You didn't? You forgot already? I did too, don't worry. Let's solder, remember these pins here. Our one and two. I'm probably going to push you off the table here. So just put you a dab here, just. And then just bridge it across. Just like you do in your FCs. For like your camera and stuff like that. I don't like the spikes. I do have bad problems for doing spikes when I do solder. Okay, let me give that a good close look. Make sure. That should be running on 2S now. Okay. Now what I like to do is when I tin everything, you see how when you turn it over, kind of just looks like BBs. So then I just kind of like, it's ugly looking. And kind of cover the pad, if you get what I'm saying. And I know you could flux it, but this solder is already fluxed up. I know you should do it anyway, but if it sticks, it sticks. Getting off angle there. I know, right? What's the point of using it as a handheld or device if you're gonna hold it? What is that there? That's something they did there, right? Yeah, that's out of that. Oh yeah, it's the UART. So we want to get that off. You see how my solder come from underneath and it touched those two UARTs together. Let's do this. Almost got it. There we go. So you want to look for that when you're tinning things. Just make sure you didn't blob too much down in there, and I apologize for that phone. Okay, so sorry about that phone again. We got everything tinned up there. Everything looks good. I'll take some alcohol and wipe it down, because you see how it's here, that resin. So you want to knock all that off with a little bit of just alcohol is fine. And I see a little bit where I missed here, but I'm not even going to use that UART. So that was just to show you guys, just go ahead and do it anyway. And I did miss the DSM port. So, but I think I'm going to run 5 volts off of one of those ports for my camera. So, but I'll show you. I kind of wanted to use this Whoop frame because it works in here, you know. It was printed perfectly for this. As you can see, goes in and allows your port to be accessible, you know. Everything's cut on the bottom for the MOSFETs to give them heat, time to cool off. But like I said, the propellers inside of here is the problem. So I got, let me show you. I have all needed to do this. XM receiver. Soft light with the Tyrannus. 8mm motors with grommets. Them holes are 8mm, so they will hold 8mm. Here's the propellers I plan on using. I might not. I do have to bore the inside of them a little bit. Would have tiny drill bits for that. But here's the dilemma. So I could just snip off the ends of them, you know, kind of center it on there, and just take toenail clippers and nip them. I may do that. Either that, or the alternative is use this frame, which it still would be cool to fly, you know. A little acro bird like this. Kind of want to have the Whoop part. You know, you can fly it in the house. This is kind of wicked in the house. RC Hunter knew that when he built her. But if I don't do that with this, I do have, I am ordering more of these boards, so I will do one with this, because I do want to get this up and flying. I really like it. I honestly do like the frame. So, you see where I'm at, and that's part one. So stay with me and check my channel out and like and subscribe. And if you're not already following, please do that. And we'll get to getting the motors mounted here. So let me make a decision right now. Will I or will I won't make the motors work? I will try this first. Let's say that. So I will go for this frame. This is the frame I am going for. So we'll see from there. And as you can see, the battery, this is the bottom. And I could print it you know, thing to hold the battery, but that's more weight. So you could just go like this, you know, put the battery in a perfect size for it. Perfect size. This also has a spot for a buzzer. You pop the buzzer in there. That way if you go outside and fly it, you lose it. You can buzz it out and find it. So alright guys, I'm upload this part here and stay with me, and maybe we'll do the receiver next. Solder on the receiver and get that talking. I already configured this, but I will show that in the end also. So there you go. Part one of the 8mm whoop-de-whoop. Plenty of power, I think it's gonna have. So, alright. Thank you guys for watching.